overseas, we find ourselves limited and not able to function to our fullest potential because of lack of adequate information. And to complicate matters, sometimes we are limited by language too. You see, so we got to find a way to interact, to come together, to share ideas, and to be able to strengthen ourselves. That's the only way we can rise and realize our potential. So what we are starting to do as a foundation is to bring awareness to ourselves in different areas of society and how different matters affecting our interests and our well-being so that we will not be left behind. So to further these aims, we work together with organizations like KK. They are like this city hall. We do different programs through radio and sometimes community meetings like this to bring out information which can be relevant and useful and beneficial to all of us who are in the diaspora. Now, this evening we're going to be discussing a topic titled Essential Male and Female Communication Skills in Relationships. You may be wondering what it's all about. Communication is a very, very important aspect of our lives. One of the reasons why we often get into conflicts and misunderstandings is that we don't communicate. To communicate, there must be a sender and there must be a receiver. There must be a speaker and there must be a listener. And but in between the listening and in between the speaking and the listening, there is a decoding of the message. There is the interpretation of the message. That's what is called semantic, that is trying to apply meaning to what has been said. And this is where things often go wrong. I'm going to get into that before I put on our speaker. But before that, I would like guests to just introduce themselves. So starting from the gentleman right in front of me. Maybe one just, yes, sir.
No,
there's a lot of voices now, so.
Good evening. My name is Juan Walter, and I'm from the KK, from the Municipal Health Service.
Yeah. Yeah, give him applause, yes. And then the gentleman next to him, yes. You need a microphone?
Yeah. Hi. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Yama Kwaji. I'm living here in 20 years now.
Okay.
Surprisingly, I hear that there's some workshop coming out this evening, so I thought maybe it's better to come around
yes.
and listen to it. And I saw that very, very important workshop
yes.
communicating between relationships,
yes.
and that is something which is causing a lot of problems in our house.
Yeah.
So I thought it's very nice we come here and
Amen.
Participate. And I'm also working here, so I'm going to give all my encouragement.
Yes. Thank you, brother.
Thank you so much.
I met him yesterday to check the place out, and he promised I was going to be here, and he kept his word. I appreciate that. Okay, next behind him is a very nice young man. He's been at a couple of our meetings. Would you please introduce yourself?
My name is Taiwo.
Engineer Taiwo. Yeah.
And I have my company as a savings advisor. And information I so much like information because without information we can't go anywhere.
That's true.
Everyone that all the migrants in this country anywhere. It's true information they get to wherever they are. So information is very, very important. And so when I write about communication between in a relationship, it's really, really a big thing, even though people neglect it, but it's the most important thing. Without communication, the love cannot grow. You can't even know each other.
Yes.
I think Wow.
Thank you.
Okay. Next to him. Yes, from Nigeria. Thank you, sir. Give an applause. Yes, another beautiful lady. Coming up.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. My name is Patience Okazu from Nigeria.
Patience Okazu. By the way, she's a powerful
seamstress. Yes.
Powerful mode fashion lady.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, it turns out to be a partner family affair too, so, well.
Pastor Mir.
Oh, sorry, skip it. Yeah,
I'm going to explain. My name is Pastor Mir from the Jesus Christ Life Church. Jesus Christ Life. I'm glad that I'm here. I'm here to come and tell you the story. So,
thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
And our speaker?
Formality. I miss somebody. Oh, I'll do that by myself. Thank you very much. Okay. Well, for tonight, our topic is actually going to be a workshop. A workshop is not just going to be a lecture. We're going to do some interaction. And that's the good part of it. Okay, so the title is Essential Male-Female Communication Skills in Relationships. But the focus or the accent is going to be on gender. Okay, and so you might be asking yourself, what is gender? Most of the time when you begin to fill forms, they put on the form gender, then you have to reply male or female. But gender is more than just the sex, the biological sexes. So gender is actually a topic which addresses the differences between men and women today. You see, and the differences which we're talking about have their roots in our culture, also have their roots in traditions. You see, so there's a difference between men and women and the way we perceive ourselves. And that also affects how we treat ourselves. Very interesting topic, but you realize that over the years, this concept of gender, it's changing the way we relate to ourselves. Now, for example, men work and women also work. So the roles in the home are changing. You see, so a man cannot treat a woman or regard a woman or expect a woman to do things, everything that she used to do before. When she was mainly a housekeeper or a domestic person. You see, so a man who's been raised up traditionally will expect the woman to be purely a domestic, chargé d'affaires, if I can put it that way. But now things have changed, and so we all are adjusting in our cultural mindset and our traditional mindset. So that is what really gender is about in a nutshell. Okay, so it's not that it's beyond the biological difference between us. So in this workshop, we will be addressing the communication skills to help us succeed in our modern-day relationships and partnerships as males and females. Now, many people don't realize how they behave because they have been programmed by their upbringing. So without addressing the communication problems which have arisen today, men and women may find it difficult to maintain stable and solid relationships and become, which have become very sensitive because of the times we live in today. don't read what I wrote. So we have to look at the issues which are coming out of the changes which are playing out in our society. So we all need to adapt culturally and as far as gender is concerned.
Bobby.
This is the core and the reason for our being here tonight. I would like to introduce the lady who's going to take us through the session tonight. Her name is called, Miss Matnack. And she is a relationship and a gender expert. Now, Emmy Diana Matnack, that's her full name, she was born in Suriname. And she has a daughter of 30 years and has been living in the Netherlands since 1972. She has had her basic teacher training education also in Suriname. Later, she enrolled and completed at the University of Amsterdam in andragogy. Is that how you pronounce it? This has to do with helping adults in their learning process. Okay? This is a special discipline which supports adults with their learning. Now, from 1996, she worked with Collective Cultural Therapies. And currently, she is a part-time family and relationship therapist at a mental institution called ISAI. Is that correct? ISAI in Amsterdam. Yeah. She is also a lecturer at the Department of Family Therapies and a freelance trainer and also a supervisor. Finally, she has published several articles to her credit. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Ms. Matnack tonight. Okay, would you like to stand here or go there? You're all comfortable this way?
Hello.
Want to hold the microphone?
Okay. Hello.
All right.
Good evening, my dear.
Okay.
I don't even know. I think you're expecting you. All right, it's good. It's good. It's good.
No, but I'm going to try also to give you some information I collect and I work with it also. Let's start.
Okay, go and sit down. Take some tea.
Would you mind to come a little bit?
Close, yeah.
Forward. You think English is not my first and not my second? Not my third language, but I learned that for you.
Take them to the front, please.
He knows very well in English, so I can like them. I'm going to open this workshop and ask you, everybody, to take one of these balloons.
Give us your telephone. You need to make some more of a cover. Oh, God, you know.
I'm not going to participate. You're going to participate. I'm going to just look and assist today.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay. I see everybody has a balloon. Okay.
Give it to me, just.
When you collect this balloon, what did you think? You can. What comes in your mind?
See whether you are seeing the
book. Blow it. Did something come in your mind? Did you manage to do something? Maybe. Okay. When you were young, or when you were at the party, what is there something that comes up?
Yeah,
when you were at the party.
The young children. Okay.
Don't do what you say.
Okay. Did somebody had I hear very, let's say, good vibrations, but maybe something comes up, oh, you see a balloon, and maybe some negative idea comes up. No? Maybe, yes? Nobody? Disappointments, maybe you think, oh, I remember once when I was 5 years, I would have a party, but my mother refused to give me a party, I would have balloons, but I don't know. If somebody has things that comes up, only good feelings comes up. Okay. Okay, that's good. Then I want to ask you to blow up your balloon. What is a balloon?
I'm not working today.
It's not working.
I'm going to assess you, but I'm not working.
Okay, you make it so the...
Sorry.
No, it's no problem. So you have to play with your balloon, but your balloon has to stay with you, and it's not allowed that it touch you.
No.
Okay, so I give you like 2 minutes.
Child come out, enjoy it. Move around and play with it. Just move and enjoy. You let them be word earlier. Not supposed to.
It's not picking up. Okay, good. You drop for a hand.
Move around and enjoy. Play with it. With your hands, with your head, with your body. Use your whole body.
I wish I have somebody to do this.
Come on, come on.
Actually, come on.
On the balloon.
That's what I hear. I have another one. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mag ik jou een advies geven?
Ja.
We vormen een halve cirkel. Ja.
Can you come? Can you have a half
cirkel? Standing?
No.
Or sitting?
Because we want a big room and then it's more, it is more.
Yeah.
Je laat me weer werken. Het is niet de bedoeling dat ik werk. Wil je een stoel hebben?
Remarks about the tenderness. If you touch the balloon very tender, stay with you. And the harder you beat it,
yeah,
the more it goes
away.
And so you can talk about different things within a relationship. The softness, respect, and tenderness. That makes you can keep the other closer to you. And with this introduction, I want to give you some more information about this theme of communication. And Pastor Larry said in his introduction that there is sometimes no communication between partners. And I know what he means, but there is always communication, even if there is no talking. And that's what I will start with. Communication is always, even people of partners don't say anything to each other. They communicate. Because there's also something like your body language, your presence. If you come in a room, somebody is sitting in that room and don't say anything. There's also communication. The fact that you don't say anything, that says something. You know? So everywhere people are of this life, there's always communication. And I already said that non-verbal communication is very important, the body language. The way you let somebody know that you appreciate, that you are listening, you know? The way you look, the tone, if you're angry, somebody can hear it in your voice.
Yes.
You know? That's always communication. So we have to be very conscious if we want to improve our communication. There are always different levels of communication. The words also said, the words somebody say, the way it sounds, the tone he chooses, the message you want to send out. One of the biggest conflict areas in the relationships is the lack of communication. In the relationships from black men, especially, and with black women, one of the biggest problems are the lack of self-disclosure.
Lack of what?
Self-disclosure.
Self-disclosure.
You know? Lack of self-disclosure. You know what I mean with that?
Maybe
you
should explain that.
Explain the lack. You don't show your deepest feelings to each other. Yeah. and also active listening to each other, the lack of active listening. Men and women used to talk about each other and not with each other. And most of the time, they communicate in an impersonal and distant way. I don't, how do you say it? I hope you don't mind that I use my paper because English is not my first language, so I want to. Okay.
No problem.
How you can improve your communication? Start creating a safe, a peaceful, and a non-violent space, non-violent atmosphere. Make eye contact with each other and show you are interested and listening actively to the other. You can show it by body language. You know, sometimes if somebody is talking to you, then you say, then people are, or you repeat what the other is saying. You know, then people know, okay, she gets me, she's listening, or he is listening. Do not start a discussion with a negative statement. Like, oh, you messed my day, you know, maybe you're angry. If you start like that way, then already the communication is spoiled. Talking the iPhone. Start talking from yourself, yeah? Talking the iPhone. So you talk about yourself and showing that you take responsibility for your own feelings. An example how you can do it is that you say, I feel ignored because you did not call to say that you would come late at home. You know, say something about how you feel. A conflict in a relationship is not bad because it can help to bring up hidden problems in a relationship. It can help to clear up differences. A conflict in itself isn't a problem. The problem is the way people handle and deal with that conflict. So that's what it's important to know that, you know, that having conflicts in a relationship, sometimes it's necessary to clean up things, you know. But it's the way how you solve that conflict. That's mostly the problem. I will give you some steps to avoid conflicts in communication. Observe, so you know what I mean, observe. And say what you see, and not what you think. Do not judge and prejudice. For Odela, for Odela's prejudice. A destructive form can be like, I think you were hanging around in a bar, like say your partner or husband came late. Then you can use destructive way, most of the time people do that. I do that sometimes also because you're angry. Then you say, I think you were hanging around in a bar instead of coming home. The other way, the positive way is like, you was at home at 8 and that wasn't what you had promised me. You know, then give the other the space to tell what happens.
Or, like you said to me, especially that young man is going to work today.
The second thing is, say what you feel and not what you think. No interpretations. Avoid to react on the reason of someone's behavior. An example is that you say, oh, you always leave your clothes on the chair because you think that it is my work as a woman to clean it up, to clean the place up, you know? But another positive or constructive way is, you can say like, I do not like when you leave your clothes on the chair. I would like you to put it in the closet.
Okay.
This is an example.
Yeah. Right.
Just put that on. And let the other know what your needs are. Say what you want and what
you need are be specific. So let me finish this. Be specific. Don't say, you know, I don't like when you talk to me like that. You know, be specific means in a constructive way. I do not like when you say that I act like a bitch. Focus on what the person had said.
I don't know. Ask whether it's possible to, like, to respond or to react to the points you are making as we go along, or you prefer to finish before we interact.
Okay.
I think we want it to be an interactive session. I don't know whether it's better to, like, when somebody has a remark or, you know, the point, then you can do it right away.
Let me show you one point.
Somebody has a comment, they can just raise their hands and comment on it.
Okay, I finish this part and then maybe somebody can do it interactively. This part is probably some steps in for a conflict. And the fourth thing is formulating questions and not demanding. You know, most of the time we're not aware that we are demanding things and not questioning.
And not what?
Not questioning.
Not questioning, we are demanding.
Give us an example. How do you mean
example? Shall I give you an example?
Yeah.
You remember we were sitting outside?
Yeah.
And you said, come in and take some tea.
I said, would you come in and take some tea?
No, it is the tone.
What happened?
It depends on.
Well, you broke my balloon.
You did. I didn't. It's on the intonation of how you say things.
Sometimes you're not aware of how the other, you know, feels it.
Wow.
But
it is also important, because our feelings are so different.
Yeah.
I discovered we communicate our feelings.
Yes.
That's a great example. But guys, they communicate very straight without feelings.
But
they
keep your point, because it's going to come. It's a very important point also about men and women, how they communicate and what is the
reaction.
The background of that, where it comes from, and what is the impact of culture and of food education in the way we react. Mm-hmm. You know, that will come out in the discussion.
Wow.
You know? Okay, I was with formulating a question and not demanding. You know? Use positive language and make it clear what you are asking. So it can also be clear for the other what your question is. So he or she can do something with it. You know, because something is not clear what the other is asking. Yeah? Because we don't point, just talk about around things. And that's also a thing of communication. That's what I didn't forget to explain that. There's also cultural bond. Yeah? Because like Western cultures, they communicate like straight. And in some other cultures, they communicate in a circle.
Yeah.
On some cultures, when you want to say something, you go first there,
then
you go there, and you don't come to the point. You know? Before you come to the point, you ask the other person, you're not coming to the point. So we can learn to the point, so it makes clear to the other person what you want to know, what you want from him or her. Okay, I said already, say what your question is so the other person knows what you want. An example is, can you please put the garbage outside?
Mm-hmm.
Next week, I would like that you put it on time. That is what we had agreed before. And what you had promised, you know, then you say exactly what was the thing you had agreed with the other. But another thing, the wrong way then is, hello, put
happened today. Okay. That's why.
But I asked Christian, the one that you said this week, I would like you to put it on time.
Yeah.
What is it? Is it not a demanding statement?
I would like.
I mean, when you say that to some men, they will take you like a man.
Yeah,
you said that to his mind.
No, you made already this week
agreement.
Yeah, you said to each other, the high Ashkab sent you that
appointment.
Agreement.
Or agreement.
You make agreement with each other that you put the garbage outside and I get Wednesday. And maybe you forgot. And you get angry. And you start you don't know that, you know. But you can say also, we had made an agreement. I remember you that we made an agreement. Can you put the garbage outside on time next time? Because it can happen that somebody forgot.
Yes, correct.
You know? Don't forget to say thank you.
But you know, in a real practical case, when everybody is in a hurry to go out in the morning, and the one that you can just bless out and say, hey, you don't know you're supposed to do that. And then the other one also picks it up and says, why are you talking to me like that? In the heat of the moment, you don't remember that you have to communicate nicely.
Yeah.
So if one says and the other replies, and cares not taking that, you know, there's a problem.
Yeah.
But unless the other person, okay, does not respond in the way it's coming, then the other can realize that he or she is speaking in not in a good way, in not communicating in a good way.
Yeah.
But sometimes you don't have your day, you know, and then you're angry from something else. Maybe you're not angry from that first particular person, but maybe you're angry on your boss. And then you react on that person. And that's far, most of the time, that sometimes makes some communication problems also. But if you keep in mind that the way you say something can help to keep communication going in a positive way. You know that we're all human beings, you know, you have it that sometimes you forget of your anger or your day. But if that happens, you can come back, come later and talk about it. You know, talking is very important. But I have, before we start the discussion, I have some more remarks for the discussion. To 7 steps to improve your communication. That what you say is less important, it is the way you say it, you know? First, initiate a dialogue. That's what I already said, start talking. Something bothers you or you can't do well, start talking. Start a conversation. Avoiding conflicts seems easier than solving it. You know, sometimes some people don't like conflicts, that they keep quiet or they say, oh. But it's better to start talking before it as always it becomes like a volcano. Of a veenbrand. I don't know the right word, but it's smelt on the ground. And then one day it comes, explode. I already said before, listen actively by giving non-verbal signs so the other can feel that you are involved and interested. Show an active listening pose by body language. Repeat what the other says. Appreciate the feelings of the other. Feelings are not wrong or good. It is his or her feelings that only express the subjective experiences from the other person. So do not interrupt. Give the other the space to express his or her feelings. And tell his or her story. Do not take over the story of the other person, but by starting to talk about yourself, because that happens a lot of time. Sometimes when somebody is telling you a story,
Okay.
But it happens lots of time, and people sometimes
sometimes are not aware of that. Sometimes someone is telling his story, and then you go away with his story. But I also had that also, and before you really realize, you don't listen anymore. So give the other person the space to tell his story and listen. And stay to the topic. Do not bring old briefs from long time ago, because that's also a thing that makes conflicts come up. That somebody's telling the story that, yeah, but 2 years ago you also said that to me, and then we lose the topic. Important is also to stay fair. Even if you feel hurt or betrayed, do not hurt the other by burning up things from the past about his or her negative sides. Iemands negatieve kant?
Side.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Be respectful and accept the differences that are between both of you or with the other. Sometimes a conflict can only be solved by agreeing that we do not agree with each other. You know, sometimes when you talk and it's okay, that's the way you see it and that's my way I see it. And sometimes when it is cleared up, then it's better that we know that we not agree about something. And that's the way you can solve also the problem. And that's no problem, because there can be more truth about something than only wrong truth. It's not only wrong truth. If you can accept that, then you can avoid that the conflict is getting bigger. Then you show respect to the other.
I see what you said, there can be more than one truth.
Your truth don't have to be the truth of the other person. But you can respect that the other has his own truth.
His own opinion.
The way he sees things in the world. If he accepts that and he can be space for it, then it's no problem.
There is a difference. There is opinion and there is truth.
Yeah.
For one person, it can be the truth, and for the other, it can be an opinion. And so there can be more truth in a story or in a situation, because every person, their own world is their truth. And if you can respect and
well, then we're talking about the subjective truth. The subjective truth here, not an objective one, because
the subjective truth.
Yeah, if it's subjective, everybody can have his own version or her own version of the truth, and that's just like the opinion, as you said.
Yeah.
Because, yeah.
But so can I finish it? Then we can start with this. This is the last thing.
Yeah.
I have.
Okay.
Sure. And the last important thing about how we can improve communication is giving and receiving instead of naming and blaming. And realize that everybody in a relationship has to put, like in the Dutch we say, one way in line. I don't know if it's
coming
into
English. Okay.
You have to be give and take. So you can compliment each other. That is possible by bringing yourself to you can train yourself to feel how it is to be in the other's place. You know, who you're in, what other's place.
Yeah.
Yeah? You know what we understand?
Yeah.
Blaming each other does not solve the problem. It only makes it and then escalates more and more. So those are the points I would share with you about this communication thing.
And I know there's lots of things will come up now. I heard already some questions and remarks. So maybe we can discuss things and share things about how we have learned to communicate. Because from different cultural backgrounds, there can be some differences. And I say every relationship, even if you come from the same country, can be a bicultural relationship. Because like if I come from Sudan and I have a Sudanese partner, then maybe we have some lots of common things, but we can differ in lots of ways. Like maybe he comes from the city and I come from the suburbs. Maybe I'm from a working class family. Farmer family. There can be lots of differences in the relationship. And you have to work on that before you can find a way to keep your balance and to respect each other in the way you differ from each other. And people forget that a relationship involving communication. That acts from everybody.
You
don't come from inside.
I used to stay longer, and they didn't have that communication. And now we're talking about communication that we learn about communicating, and now we're having more problems than we used to have when there was no communication between partners.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
The question is that how come that before, in the past?
Yes.
There was
no communication between the husband and the wife.
Mm-hmm.
I can say if I talk about Africa, the wife didn't have any right to make a decision at home
mm-hmm.
or to say anything.
Mm-hmm.
But they lived happily.
Yes.
They lived longer.
For years.
So now we're talking about communication.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And we're communicating.
That's a good one.
And we're learning about communication and work, but still we're having more problems now.
Yes.
The partners are having more problems mm-hmm. than they had before. So what is missing here?
What do you think?
I think I know.
What is it?
Yeah.
I think that the women are challenging them.
No, I think.
I disagree with that. The thing I see is because the demand in the present day
yes.
is more than the demand in the olden days.
Mm-hmm.
In the olden days, like in Africa, the system of the world. Which is only one of the decision. And if the decision is wrong, then the economy will have to take it like that. But now, in the new day, now the decision can be spread out. So this is because as a result of this, there is the development. It's because of the development.
We still want to do.
I'm not working today.
I agree with him.
You want to say something?
Yes. Because, like you said about culture and origin.
What?
Culture and origin.
Yeah.
Like I might say, where we come from. Why it seems that their marriage or their relationship lasts longer is because of the community. Because where I come from, for example, when you are married, you cannot come out of your marriage. Because when you come out of your marriage, you don't have any chance anymore to remarry.
Yeah.
So that will also keep women stay with their husbands.
Even if
they are not happy. Because not all of those marriages that last, we are good. Because we have also record of who killed their husband or who killed their wife. Because that gives them also, like, even now you see happening. Some people are in relationship not because they are happy, but maybe they are waiting to get where to go. And people see them. And some also try to show people that they are happy. people give an example of how happy they are. Mm-hmm. Till suddenly you had that one of them kill each other.
Come on.
Yeah. Wow. I want to know what your reaction there. Is that true? No.
I think people are not tolerant at this modern time. There's lack of tolerance. And people are no more into, it's like everybody is into relationship for one thing or the other. And then people are not really very real. It's like people are becoming too plastic. Yeah. But in the olden days, like our mothers, I think they endured relationship. They endured, not that they enjoyed, they endured relationship. So they were into marriage even when it's not very comfortable, but they are into it, and then we think it's lasting. But now the modern day man or woman, they know what they want. So they just want it. If A is A, it's A. It's not like if A, then it's A, you say C. So they just want it direct. Uh-huh. And then some people are not ready to cope up with those who are very straightforward. They still want to do their communication in a zigzag manner. So when you pair people like that, somebody who is straightforward and somebody who is so, it doesn't work.
Also, we only can communicate well when we want, when we have the same objection or the same focus. For example, so many people are in relationship, but at the beginning, what they want is not the same. Maybe each one of them lied to each other. For example, a woman wanted that relationship maybe to turn into marriage, but the man also wanted that relationship for a short time. Just giving an example. It can be any side. So when you have, maybe you have more focus on that relationship, and the other person is like, is in a trap. It's finding an excuse to go away. And that is why sometimes I can communicate with you, but I cannot communicate with her. When I am with you, we always have a problem. When I am with another person, we are understanding each other. Yeah.
And that's supposed to be your partner. You are not understanding your partner. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
You can communicate well with an outsider.
Not outside. I say sometimes I can communicate with her.
Yes.
And maybe when we are in a marriage, we quarrel. And when we stop the marriage, I went to another person, we are happy. She went to another person, they are happy. Mm-hmm. You understand that?
Yes.
Okay, that means both two partners are not compatible.
Yes.
And some of the things lead to that. Mm-hmm. Maybe there is some people, they always want to be apologized. Always expect you to come and say, forgive me. And there is some people, that's the last thing they can say.
I'm going to structure this discussion because you want to say something. Mm-hmm. What's first?
Okay. Mm-hmm. In a relationship, before you go into a relationship, of course, you should be in friendship first.
Friendship?
At that stage, you go understand each other. I'll take my own relationship as an example. When my stepmom and my mom dated, after a while, we used to argue, we talk, we argue things out. After a while, when we get to see them, we could move this thing ahead. We call each other and we can agree. Write what you want and what you don't want. And write down what you know what it means. Me too, I have to do the same thing, and then we give it to each other. And then we go to study this. Then we come to each other, then we make an agreement. this is this, and we give a period on this. We're able to do this because we respect each other. So in a relationship, there must be respect. And before this, you have to make a friendship first. It is very good to make a friendship first, because in this friendship, you will know the likes and the don'ts, you know? So, if you have this before the relationship will start, you already know that, yeah, with this one, I can't change this one. This one cannot change me. Then the two of us cannot grow along much more. Then from there, you know that this woman, she only wants this friendship for a short period. And if you want that, good. You go ahead. If you don't want that, good. You stay just friends. And you look for somebody else. So, but in the olden days, on the other way around, the parents are the ones that are choosing the partners of the children. So this is why there is an hierarchy. A man will always be one of them because of the culture, because the law is a sweet law. Like my brother said, you can't easily go out of marriage except the other one die. You know, so
that has changed now.
Yeah, and now, due to information like this, women have their voice out, because I noticed that in men, they think why women structurize that whiteness.
Yeah,
so they structurize it, you know, like as it's said that behind the great man, there is a strong woman. That's why the man who has the vision, but the woman is the one that making that action on the ground or in any way. So, in a relationship, they both have to have a good understanding. They have to have a good idea, and it shouldn't be one man making a decision, because like a man. I really respect his dad now, Steve Jobs. In his organization, the man, when this man talk, you know that, yeah, this man is wise, Steve Jobs.
Okay.
You know,
oh,
yes. He said in his organization, they asked him that, are you always right in your decision making? He said, no. He said, no. I'm not always right. I give opinion. My employer, my partners, we fight. We disagree to agree. They have opinion. The best opinion is going to be the decision.
But then we come up another issue from this evening. Is you start talking about how come marriage nowadays, marriage. Relationships difficult to last, and one thing that comes up is what do you think about the law? That the law now are more interfering in family life. You know, give women more opportunity, give women more friends, more protection, and. What makes also that the position of women and men in the society and also in the relationship is different than years before? And another thing that comes out in my mind is how do you see the difference between men and women in a relationship? Because if you talk about communication, then I hear a lot of people are saying that there's a big problem in communication between men and women, because lots of men haven't learned to talk. In a traditional way, men are doing things, men are working, and they do things. They don't deal a lot with emotions. They haven't learned it.
they didn't socialize that.
Yes, exactly.
But the society is demanding that from men.
Yeah.
That they have, and women are demanding that from men. They have to communicate. Yeah? And what I always see also in my therapy is that that's sometimes a big problem, because the men say, yes, but okay, you want to talk, okay, let's talk. One of them say, okay, you can talk, but that's not a real talk. And the man shows that he don't know how to talk. So he has to learn some skills.
That's not totally true.
What do you say, Juan?
That's not totally true.
That's not totally
true. There are men who can communicate, and there are men who doesn't. Even as there are women who can communicate, and there are women who cannot communicate.
You know?
The thing is how they are being socialized. Because if you're from a household where the role from the men and the women are defined and respected, men learn in that environment to communicate. When it doesn't being defined, then you have a problem.
But that's what I say.
Yes.
I say...
No, and that's why I intervene.
I hear from lots of women in my therapy, men and women, that there's a problem in communication.
Yes.
And what you do is that you're going to find out how both are socialized. You know, how they have learned to talk or to communicate or not communicate with each other. And then we can see that lots of men didn't get all these skills from home.
Yeah.
You know?
Can I do something?
No, not yet.
Okay. I'm just asking.
He said he don't want to work.
Yeah, he said he don't want to work.
But at times I want to work.
You know, woman has, even if you don't say it's not true or not, women most of the time have some more, is that the forestrong sometimes?
Advantages.
You know, we say this society is very feminized, you know. It demands feminized skills also for men.
Mm.
And that's what men, lots of men feel, that the they are putting lots of pressure on them in a relationship to do things that they sometimes they haven't learned from home. So there is a lot of work to do. That's why I said before that in a relationship nowadays, you have to work together on that.
You know, very important key in our relationship that I have to learn.
foundation that you built. If your relationship starts with good communication and openness to one another, what do you like and what you don't like? What don't make you happy and what make you happy? To each other, just be open. I think it makes relationship in this modern day so much easier than hiding things. Today, when people start having relationship, I believe people, not everybody, I don't talk, but some group of people really don't want relationship. They want sex with each other. And after they have the sex experience, they find out, my God, I make a mistake. I shouldn't. What have I done? But there's no turning back in some point, because in some culture you must marry her because probably you have sex with her and she got pregnant. So there's no way of turning back. So you are heap up with something that you're like, what I'm gonna do now? So that's the thing I believe, that people, the foundation for a relationship is the communication. That people, what he said is that have friendship with each other. To get to know each other well. It doesn't matter or the modern day or the days years ago. Well, the days before our grandmother, they were living under pressure because you cannot marry twice. It's a shame to your family, so you don't have your own opinion. But I believe in these days, if you have a good communication with each other and the wine, you bring the wine, water, you put the water in wine, give them the respect. Try to know what the man like and try to know what the woman like. You know, and then you can know what, I think if you don't know, maybe you bring a red flower, why she loves yellow flower. You know, what kind of taste she want, you bring her something. And that's our things. I think if you get to know what is interesting in the other person, it makes relationship much easier.
I'm still not allowed to talk. I'm still not allowed to talk.
You are not doing no work today. So
he told me that he don't want to
talk today. So let him talk.
He just wants to keep quiet.
Let's I want you to talk.
But I
talk, please.
I'm gonna make two remarks. One of them is what I miss is we are talking like we are not men and women. And I want you to talk like men and women. And if you are talking about the men, address us so that we have that communication together. And if we as men are talking, we will address you as women and ask you things, because that will help us understand. Because we are talking like we are not sitting here. You understand what I'm saying? And this is a workshop. And my sister is giving a workshop. So talk to each other. Ask each other.
And they're not talking.
No, they are talking. They
must talk to us as women. They must. What he's saying is that they must talk to us, and then when we want to talk, we talk to them direct. Like now, I want to ask question. Why is it that, in this communication skills, many women are not very open. Many of us are not very open to say what we want. But I've come to realize that men are very ignorant.
You find us ignorant.
Yeah, they are very, very ignorant. But some of them have a corrective heart. Like, let's assume my husband, most of the time, he will carry his laptop and he will come to the bedroom and put the laptop in between our bed. So then I said to him, no, you've been working with this laptop for the whole time. So I don't want the laptop in my bed, please. So, but I found out that many women are not able to say what they want. But when I said to him, I don't want the laptop, then he got iPad. So, he doesn't carry the laptop, then that is the iPad. And then before the iPhone. So all the time you see him just very, very busy with iPad.
I thought this long ago.
You're doing again what I'm asking you not to do. If you want to know why he is coming with the laptop or the iPad to bed, ask the guy.
Right. Now, Mr. Larry Dokeni, what is the reason why you normally come to the bed with iPad or your iPhone? Is it that there is something lacking?
Well, I believe.
Or is it the part already. Of a? Is it the part of a man? Or that men don't like to talk too much?
No. I think we settled this already because when you said you didn't like it, I believe I stopped.
Yeah.
So that is a settled issue.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, already. But what I'm trying to say is that to some women, they will not have the boldness to say to their husbands, like,
okay,
don't bring iPad, don't bring iPhone. To the bedroom.
Yeah, it depends on the understanding between two of them. If the husband is a kind of a violent one,
yeah,
you know, the woman will be afraid, won't want to say her feelings out.
Yeah.
Yes.
You're gonna keep it like that. You understand? But like your husband is, yeah, he's not the type.
No.
This was why you're being open. To speak out, you understand? So this kind of information, that's why we have this kind of information now. There are some men that are now, like you said, for that, from home, it is more usual for the disease, and individual thing. Some people, they brought them up well from home, but at the end of the day, they turn the other way around. What they say, is it the same from home? No. So it's something individual. So we just have to be transparent. In a relationship, before you go into a relationship, you are ready to be transparent.
I need to come in here, if you permit me. I think that is a very good point. We need to really improve, get the understanding. Because most of us, and that's what I want to relate to, we're talking about gender. The gender aspect of our topic mustn't be overlooked. You know, the roles of men and women have changed so much. In the past, women didn't have a say, didn't have the authority to speak to a man. But now, women have the chance, they have the authority to speak as well. they are going to stand up to their men to say what they like and what they don't like. And I think women should take advantage of that and be able to know what are women like. In fact, sometimes when I go to shop with my wife,
yes.
I'm amazed at the variety of, let's say, the sizes and the colors which are there. It's amazing. It blows my mind. Women are pretty straightforward, you know. But women have set variety of choices. The same applies to them in, let's say, other details of their likes and dislikes. So if we can take time and to get to know what suits our particular woman, I think it will be very, very good. Sir, you want to say something?
Can I take another dimension on this? I mean, I've just walked in, so I'm sorry to hijack your meeting.
Go
ahead. I'm thinking, our friend here is saying, let's make it real. Men say what men are saying, women say what women are saying, but let's speak so that we're actually communicating. I have another tack in this, on communication, something I've thought about a little bit, more than a little, more like a lot. And that is, we that are trying to communicate with another, whether that be another woman, another man, our God, our friend, our whoever, do we know ourselves?
Can we
actually communicate with ourselves? Do we know what we want to say? Do we know what we want? Do we know who we are? Before we are trying to tell somebody what we actually want, do we know what we want? It's easy to say, I don't want this, and I don't want that. But can we answer the question, when someone asks you, what do you want, can you actually answer it? My wife asks me sometimes, what do you want? I say, I don't know. I wasn't bringing a person to be sexually active before I got married. So when she asks me, what do I want, I'm like, I don't know. That's being real. I don't know. What will please you? I don't know. Does she know? I don't know. Does she know what she wants? I don't know. So we're trying to communicate here on a level where, okay, that's in a marriage relationship, but that's because we can get that close and we can ask those kind of questions. Outside the marriage relationship, when we're talking to our colleagues at work, our friends at home, even you guys here. Why did you come to this meeting or this workshop? Why did you, well, I mean, I know why I was diverted here, but I know that God has a plan purpose and design for everyone, so nothing happens by chance. But the point is, do we know what we want to communicate? Do we know who we are? Do we know what we want? Because you're communicating something because either you want to tell something to somebody, you want to enhance that person's life, or you want to enhance your life in some way, shape, or form. So that's my two pennies that I put in there.
Now, I think before you came, we had some lecture sharing. And one of the four principles is your own needs. You know, find out what all your own needs are. And that's a lot of work. You know, when you start a relationship with each other, I am very selfish. And I see a lot of white people come in therapy. And I say to black people that a relationship is something that you have to work on it from the beginning. And it starts with yourself. You have to find out a lot of things. I already said that every relationship is like a bicultural relationship. When we talk about bicultural relationship, we think it is about a white man, a black man, or a white woman. Two black people from the same country can have a bicultural relationship. And when you want to find out what your differences are, you have to start with yourself. How am I socialized? What are the beliefs I got to be from how to start a relationship? What do I feel? What are my needs? It's a lot of work. Before you can come to put everything together and find the balance and know where the differences are, we already said that in a relationship there must be differences. But you have to talk about it. You have to find out what it is. And accept also that there can be differences. We have talked about truths and opinions. There can be many truths. So in these short workshops, we highlight some things. That doesn't mean that you always you already have everything to. It's a starting point.
But Ermi, you're forgetting one essential thing that the gentleman said. How is the relationship with yourself? Have you learned to have a relationship with yourself?
But that's what I say.
Yeah, but how do you start with yourself? Because that's the question.
You start with yourself when you come in therapy, in family therapy. But I start with everybody himself to work out your past, work out the way you have socialized, the belief you have, and the way you think about yourself, and before you can think about the relationship to the other. And that's a long way to go. And that's first the relationship to yourself. You know, I have developed a workshop, Domestic Harmony. And when I say about domestic harmony, sometimes people think it's about your house and the relationship. But the house, the first house, that's yourself.
Exactly.
Yeah? That's your temple. Yes. You have to start within yourself. Yes. To keep balance in yourself, to know yourself. Exactly. That's your first house. Wow. Yeah? And that's the metaphor that we use. Yeah? You have to listen carefully. Yeah? When I say a house, I don't mean that house only where you live. I mean your own house, where you live in yourself. Find the balance there. And that's the first work you have to do.
You're preaching, but there are two people.
You're preaching.
Well, I need to, let me interrupt. I am the moderator, so I'm not already stepping up. I guess we could continue whole night because everybody has input. Can we wrap up in the next 10 minutes or so? Can we put everything together, finish everything up in the next 10 minutes? Yeah. So we don't overstay our time. Whichever direction you take it, I want you to bring up clearly, or I want us to bring up clearly, the aspects of gender influence on our relationship today? I mean, which skills, communication skills, do we need to have to be able to live in harmony with ourselves and with one another? If it's possible to highlight or touch on some of those things, I think it would be nice. Will we fulfill tonight? You want to use the microphone?
Well, you see, it's very difficult to say things because I already said some things about yourself, from the way you have socialized, the way you have raised up, the beliefs that your education as man and as a woman, what do men want, what you have learned, how you have raised up. In what family you have raised up? Did you have a father at home? Did you learn to think? Did you have role models at home? How was his example to you? You know, and that makes the way you be it also in the relationship. Because there must be differences between man and woman, but that's not the problem. You need to be aware what the differences are and how you deal with that in your relationship. So, what the gender aspects of relationship things in between men and women, it depends also on the culture. You see, because if I talk about a Surinamese person or somebody from Africa, there can be some differences. It's also some things that you can say in the overeenkomst.
Similarities.
So it's difficult to talk in an main way. If it is a workshop, I just want to know from you what you have learned as a man how to be in a relationship, and what the differences are. But I cannot dictate what the differences in gender and relationships. What's your question?
I was saying, is it possible to highlight some of the differences, cultural differences or traditional differences, or changes which we must, adjustments in the relationship we need to have now to be able to live well with our, with our partners?
Yeah.
Because we all grew up with a different cultural and social baggage. And then we come to meet together, and now we have to adjust to each other to be able to live together in a relationship.
Yeah.
Okay, and then our world also has changed. It's not like where we came from in our village where everybody was like together and everybody, we knew ourselves very well.
Yeah.
Now we're in a global village, you meet a total stranger, you fall in love, you get married, or whatever, you have to stay together. Now, what are some of the changes which we need to adopt so that we can coexist with one another in today's world, in terms of communicating?
I talked also something before about that communication, that openness, respect, accept that there can be differences in the relationship, talking, initiate the dialogue, be open. I called a lot of things before, what is important to put a base together so you can improve your relationship with each other.
Yeah.
And that starts with this giving and receiving.
Mm-hmm.
Putting also, we have to say that bereid zijn. You have to be
approachable or reachable? Prepared.
Rather by the language, that might be saying in Dutch. It's like, maybe I can take an example of the Dutch government now, to rule the country. You cannot rule the country with one party, one political party. In this country, there's also more than one. And that means that you have to, they call it the Polen. In Holland, they call it Polen, so that you can work together to rule this country. And that's like in a relationship. There are differences, and if you want to your relationship be successful, you have to put one thing right. You have to give and take. You have to be respectful. You have to know what you
where it comes from. If I work with partners, it takes very long, and they come maybe 15 or 20 times, and every time we focus on a certain issue. We work from with the one person from his whole background, all the tips, you think how you socialize, what are the beliefs, how you think about a woman's position, the role of a woman in your life, and then we go step by step. Till we come till now in your relationship, what you expect from each other, what you want to give and what you want to take. So all the things have to be clear in your relationship.
Let me add what the brother is saying. I think this is a very important thing that we should really it's very important to know who you are. Mm-hmm. Who you are. Yeah. And then when you know who you are, you know what you want in your life, it is easier for you to let the other person come in and say, this is what I want, this is who I am, and this is what I want in my life. That person will see whether he wants to come into that in your life the way you want it. But then also the other person has also a way of life. Then whether you blend it. But also when you have to respect, you have to respect yourself. Because if you don't respect yourself, you don't expect me, if I don't respect myself, I don't expect me to respect a man. Because I don't respect myself, that's the fact thing. So the way I treat myself is the way I'm going to treat the other one. So we have to have knowing yourself, respecting yourself, because when you respect yourself, you can respect also other people.
Yeah.
And then also knowing how to listen.
Mm-hmm.
You have to listen, start listening to yourself. Because it's in that way you can also listen to other person and then give balance.
Yeah. You know, all these things are important. But the most of the problems are that lots of people haven't learned these things from home to know how to improve yourself, how to know yourself, how to learn to know yourself.
I think
so you need also some work on that.
I think that is a great topic. We have all learned, most of us have learned these things at home, but most of us have, we have, some of, most of us have learned this at home, especially at home, who are told to be this way at home, respect, the value of respect. But we also have to know that the world we live in now is also another world which is bringing us. The world is we're challenged with things in the world. You know, the way we dress, the way you talk, the way you move, the way people you have to be with, those kind of things. That's also we're trying to also to fight with also this. That is also another thing. It's a challenge.
I agree with you, Madly. I think people have to be very conscious and have a discernment of what is right. What is the right? You might be coming teaching from home. In all days where I come from the ghetto. And in all ghetto said the more you're, you know, the more the guy like you, but that's a lie. Not every guy like a woman that's a, like a bitch. Let's be real. But the teacher from home, you have to be, you know, gangster, then a man will like you. No. So you have to be able to say, is this it? And you have to be come to the point to be honest to yourself.
How do you do that?
When you know the right, when you know the truth, then you say, hey, do I look like the truth? My life resemble, do it look like what is the right way of behavior? Because you might be defending yourself. People that, if you keep on defending yourself, like, I don't do this, there's no way for change.
What I want to know, because it doesn't come itself. How do you have to come from a man, I say a mental position, man, you have to come out of yourself, of that old things you have learned, to look of yourself and change.
No, you need a mirror.
Change yourself.
And that's why we need a role model.
You have to reflect. Learn to reflect on yourself and look at yourself. Yeah? That the things you have learned from home and that you want to change. That's hard work. But I want to know how we do that.
It's a process. I do believe in a process. If you come from a home and they knew, you know, your mother always wore shirt, dress. So it's just not that I'm judging. So you're very sexy because that's what you're used to, that's what you see. But when you come out and you see, you come out and you see a, like mirror, hey, this is not the way to dress to go to a solicitation spec. You know, I cannot dress this way. They won't take me because, but you grow up from home to dress, and so you need a mirror. That's why the role models are very important. Or I don't know what your belief, maybe you might believe in the Bible, and then you get your value from, hey, it's different. Then you confront yourself. Hey, is this, and you begin to be true, you speak true to yourself. And I believe if you are open and willing to go in the process,
yes,
there is change for you. Because life is a process. If you take 2 years, 10 years time to mess up, being hurt, go through all stuff, then you don't believe that it will work in 1 year. You need also maybe 15 years to come out of that mess again.
That is why, again, saying knowing yourself. You have to know yourself. You have to learn how to know yourself. You have to learn how to wait. Yeah. All those things they say a process. It is you to learn to know who you are.
Yeah.
If you don't know who you are, then it's very difficult.
Okay.
Can I just add one thing to what you're saying?
Mm-hmm.
I think once you've known yourself, you've also got to trust yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Because what you say, you need to know that you know that you know that it's true.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way you want to go. Because if you don't trust yourself and you second guess yourself and you're always thinking, what's that other person saying about me? What's that person saying about you? And I can tell you that every single person will say something different. So you've got to know who you are. And you've got to trust that you know who you are. I personally have lived my life looking at other people and taking a little bit of good from here, a little bit of good from there, trying to change my life according to what I think is the right way. My baseline is the Bible, but not everything is in the Bible in today's world. And therefore, I have to look at it and see, look, how does this apply to me? How does this impact me? And that's how I live my life. Valued on Christ, but also looking at Christ's creation and saying, look, I think this is a good attribute in this person. Do I have that same attribute? Would I like to obtain that attribute? How do I do that? And so trusting yourself, when I say knowing yourself, I also add all the attributes that you have given and that they have given. Because not everybody had good parents. Not everybody had parents. Not everybody have had the very, very blessed life that I have had. To have the parents that showed me part of the way. But they only showed me part of the way.
And do you need your role models to help you? I said, do you need role models?
This is what I'm saying. You look at other people. I look, I look at other people. I see some good attributes in some of them. I take those good attributes and say, do I have those attributes? Would I like to have those attributes? Are they things that would enhance my life? Are they things that would make me more like Christ? Yes or no? Then I adapt accordingly. Because we are human beings, we can adapt. And we can improve our lives, in my opinion.
My brother here says, what about love? We're talking about everything, other things. What about love? What do you
mean?
Chemistry.
If there is no chemistry, then you can work on it as long as you want. This base of relationship, love, and chemistry.
Yeah.
And then everybody is right.
Yeah.
Everybody's points are coming after that. And they go right. But it starts with love and chemistry.
Okay, on that, on my own opinion, about love, when you respect, if you respect your friend, if you resent your respect,
yeah,
you will be in love.
Yeah, but first you meet somebody, you fall in love.
Exactly, I get you.
You end up this intense feeling of true love, chemistry, and then respect comes after that.
Yes.
You start to learn each other. You build up this friendship.
Yes.
You have to know yourself. Everything comes together with that. But if you don't have love and chemistry, you're not alone.
Yeah, but that thing is not wrong thing, huh?
She was right. I think she can't bear to be a month without her husband. You will get crazy because you still love him. Otherwise, you will not be with him for 10 years, 13 years. And you still have to work on it. That's the process that she's talking about. It's a whole process. But you know yourself, that's what he says. You know what you want to learn.
then you start falling in love with nature, then you have this chemistry, then you build up this everything. Then communication will go.
So it's also the chemistry. Also, I learned that my chemistry is not as this.
True. You still can combine it as one. Yes. And that is love. If you can't combine it, then our love.
There is a difference when you talk about chemistry or love. Love have to do, I can love a lot of people or I can love one person in a special way. Chemistry has to mostly to do with the physical part of it. So what are you talking about? Are you talking about the physical part of it or are you relationship is something that you can work on if you really care for the other.
No, what do you mean is that it's someone don't like a man that is short or long. So it's first when you see the person, you say, hey, I like this man or I love him. Hey, you talk to each other from there, it starts.
Still, we are talking about you have the physical attraction and you have the spiritual attraction.
But there cannot be spiritual attraction unless there's first a physical attraction.
That's not always true.
I'll say it's
that's not always true.
I strongly disagree.
If I may,
the path you're going down leads you to the path that fancy this person, which is basically what you're talking about. You fancy this person today, 2 years down the line, you see someone else, you fancy that person just because of the way they look.
No, yes. I mean, if I'm walking on the street and I see a good looking guy, right? In my eyes, he's good looking, right? My guy is long, short, then that's the first way of communicating. None or language is communication. I see him, you look at me, hey, short lady, then there it starts.
But this attracts
you. But if there's
together.
Okay.
Yeah. So feel free and go ahead. They will bring it in.
Yes. What I was trying to say, I share the idea of her because when you see someone, and you the first impression, how the person looks.
I don't eat
the way
rice.
She looks.
What would you buy me?
Only
salad and chicken, and I will take it with me.
So good. I have to have thank
you.
No
who sent you well? Don't
worry. This is that you're a good man, I see.
Maybe you're not comfortable. But if I'm not attracted to the person, I don't have interest.
I think you talk about different levels.
I talk about what he said.
I think you talk about different levels because attraction, love, spiritual feelings. I think it's another dimension.
In a relationship, if it's what you're calling, you get to know her, then maybe the feeling comes, the thing comes later, even maybe she's not your type.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you can be with somebody who's not your type, that's it real. But some people, you meet them at the first attraction, then you say, hey, let's move on. Who's your name?
What then you got to learn that people. And then love, maybe love can come, and then love can improve, and love go deeper.
Yes.
And it's not only love, you say spiritual. And I think that's another level of the relationship. Yeah? That doesn't have to do only with attraction and so on. You have another connection. It's like a soulmate, a soul, and love and soul. Yeah, I don't know.
Let me ask one question.
Yeah.
Based on, there are certain assumptions you're making. You said it's not my type. How do you know what your type is?
I
I don't want to answer the question. You see what I'm going with this?
No,
so
no.
I
just want to be on the base, to be real. Okay?
Be real.
If I take it up to Christianity, then you will say, okay, you got a lot of person, but just be real on the daylight. Young people, how you as young people move forward, you see somebody and you feel attracted to them.
Yes.
That's the first step.
Yes, that's the first step to be seen.
And thereafter, you want to know the character, who they are, who's their mother, what's their name, where they come from, who's the
whatever.
I started
with my fellow man, and the question he asked me. That goes to you. And the last question, my time. I see this man. I know I'm a great man. I'm not very nice. And I'm trying my books to so I watch this woman over and over flowing. She will not be aware. See how she comes. This is my time. The way she dressed.
Can you say?
The way she dressed, yeah.
This is my partner. If you need a microphone,
speak
up so we can hear you.
That will
help you.
No, like you said, modern. This is a type of coffee, group dancing girls. This is not my time. I go to church. I see how the person is singing and worshiping God and gentle and silent questions. I'm telling you to people, I say, this is my time. Every man. And everything starts with first sight. First sight. Feelings. Listen, know what I'm saying. My type is to have a tall woman. My type is to have a woman with fair complexion. Or black woman. I need black, really black woman. That's my type. Then, the other thing follows that her character. I need to study her. Some fellow women in the metro, fellow the same woman in the metro, in the bus, going, watching the behavior of that woman. So it is everything starts with first sight. The attraction you get, the communication you have, through her behavior, her character. You watch the person, if she's moving with two or three girls, you watch them how they talk. This is my type. The way she dressed, this is my type. The way she act, this is my type. The color, this is my type. The height, this is my type. So everything starts with first sight. Then that is chemistry. Then the love will come into it. Okay, the move. And when you move towards that person,
what did
you
say?
The way she responds to her answers to her questions and the approach. It's another thing to do, to feel that you love that person. So everything starts, just as my dear brother, sister was saying, you can't just get somebody overnight and say,
it's not like a business deal.
No, it doesn't work so. No matter what.
You are real,
can I say something, Ernie? Okay. I think, can you hold this
so
I can focus?
Yeah.
I think that we are talking about different things. We are mixing things together.
Yes.
One has to do with, if I see somebody, what are the criteria I use to find a person attractive or not? Doesn't have anything to do with being in a relationship. Secondly, we started this discussion at the beginning of talking about our parents compared with us or the youth from now. In the old time, people sometimes felt in love and sometimes they grew to love or to respect each other. And they choose to be together based on certain qualities of the person. Nowadays, we are focused more in what they earn, how they look like, how they behave, and things like that.
How they dress.
Precisely. So,
that's the real now.
Now for you and for me and the generation now. In the old times, it was there, but it wasn't visible because people were arranging a lot of things. And you can... The thing I was surprised to hear that women didn't have power then. They had the power. It was on another level.
There are still lots of arranged relationships.
Precisely. And still people... Yeah. And so, let's take the things out of each other. Are we talking about relationship? Are we talking about communication? Or are we talking about gender? And if we want to mix them, be clear on which level do you want to mix them. So that you can know what you can learn from it.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
Are you talking of communication in let's say, in modern world, like we African? You see, we have different environments.
The thing is, we African doesn't exist.
Here, you can, the communication will be free.
Okay.
It can be easy. But what of those people now, you can go home, as I can go home to marry.
Yeah.
You know, the woman cannot talk like a woman here. She cannot express herself like a woman here. She has the reserve respect in everything.
The
she
thing
can't
is,
express herself anyhow.
There are other
but
rules.
Here, women can express herself.
But the ways of communication.
There are other rules. The thing is, we don't need to think that in the Western world, the woman has. There are rules how people relate to each other. You know? And back home, there are other rules. But the women there, they know the space they can use to speak up. Because a lot of times, it isn't about who is in charge. It's how you communicate and how you define power. So, in communication, it is about giving respect and getting respect. If I don't respect you, probably I will not get respect from you. So if I'm gonna try to be the one who is overpowering you, I can do that, but there is no communication. And the men back home knows that. They know that they have a certain space that they can deal and do their thing, even as the women. And the same in and things are changing and powers are changing. And we need to realize that. Because if you don't realize that, you're in trouble. That's the reality.
Okay. The last.
I think the topic we are discussing here is communication. And that some minutes ago, I see we going out of the topic. What I think we're supposed to focus on is the obstacles in communication.
Yeah.
And one of the obstacles we have in communication is understanding. Like the example you give, you can tell your partner, ah, you know, it's the money you have to throw to the person. The way you, the tone, sometimes we command. We don't know that we are commanded.
Mm-hmm.
Then the other person has seen the other one as using, taking her like a servant or a slave.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was a time I used to have that problem. I can tell my wife or my girlfriend, give me water. Mm-hmm. Say, but please. Don't say, give me water. Say, please.
Please, give me water, yeah.
I learned it. Then anytime I want to, sometimes I say please before I say, I tell you please, man. Please, please, please. This will be happening. Sometimes what we say, we don't know how it works for that person. And so people don't want to come back and tell you, I don't like what you say, or the way you
said it. Yeah.
Your word, or the tone. Yeah. I think we should really focus on that so that we can go. Something from him.
Yes.
than talking of maybe seeing somebody that one is not communicated in relationship.
Yeah.
About people who have relationship already, how they can communicate, how they can make amendment for their relationship or for their marriage.
Right. Thank you. You brought us back on track. Your host.
My host asked me to stop. So we're going to stop, but we're not finished this discussion. I think it's going to continue. There's a lot to say about this issue. Yeah?
Mm.
Because communication is something that's continuous. It's not stopping. Yeah?
Yes.
So I want to thank all of you for this, your better, how you say it?
Contributions.
Discussion,
and
I hope I could share with you something I had give you before, and that you can do something with it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please.
Well, we've come to the end of the show. A lot has been said. As more of fact, I realized that we veered off the main topic, and I'm glad you made that remark at the end, that we were going to talk about other things, you know. Well, it looks like they're all connected, and I think whoever said it found it important. So we can't just say it was totally off track. That notwithstanding, I believe we've had a fruitful evening, you know, at least interacting, getting to know ourselves, if we're not in our thought, at least having the chance to share a laughter or a smile together. I would like to especially appreciate our guest speaker, the one who facilitated this workshop this evening. Those of you who came to Lucas, we had some fun game. You know, that's why you see the balloons over here. I wish you were here in time, you would have enjoyed it. Next time, I'm sure you'll come here. to appreciate our guest this evening, I would like to invite my wife to present her a token of our appreciation. May we have, please, the Reverend Mrs. Dawkin. Hello. Harry.
Thank you.
This is the lady who actually is the motto behind our radio program. As I mentioned earlier, she actually is the one who initiated it, and the reason why today we can have programs like this, not only on the radio but also publicly like this, you know, we can come together and to discuss topics which affect us all. So here you are.
Thank you so much. Well, I thank every one of you this wonderful evening who have really sacrificed your precious time to be here. I'm very grateful, and I just want you to know that relationship is very important, and anything we can do to enhance our relationships, what can I say than to say a very big thank you. Please. So I also want to thank my bosom friend, the one who is holding the camera tonight, even though he said he stopped working. I want to thank Juan for making time to come here. He's a very nice person, a very nice man, and very open. So he has been encouraging us to do something to bring our community together. So Juan, I just want to say thank you so much. And one of this, I'm taking you straight to Africa, I'm taking you to Nigeria, then you can just reach there.
That's so, okay, thanks.
So please, we cannot really pay for what you have given to us. But from our heart, we just want to say a very big thank you, and we think you can just use this one to drink just coffee for tomorrow morning. God bless you. Thank you. always good to cherish relationship. I cherish these two people I just made mention of. They are very dear to us. You know, we are in a community or in a society where people are too busy. They don't see what is in other people. But I'm so glad that Juan was able to see the things that are inside me, not only as a pastor, but he looked beyond to see that I can have the influence to talk on special topics like this, which will help our community. So I'm very grateful, and I treasure that relationship. And I thank every one of you once again, because you are dear to us. That is why you are here. May God richly, richly bless you. There are some of you who have been coming to all our programs. Look at my story, like the humble engineer, like the other one. May God richly bless every one of you. And we trust that we will continue to work on our relationship and work on our communication skills. God bless you.
Before we go, I would like to acknowledge that we have also some here who represent some organizations.
Yes.
We would like to at least introduce yourself and your organization. Let me first give the chance to Dory. Come,
yes.
Just a minute to introduce yourself and your organization and what you are doing.
Yes. My name is Dory Edenberg. We have a children foundation for orphanage children. Me and her and another girl. I just came from India and Dubai, where we have seen children, a lot is going on. We take care of children that don't have father and mother and are on the street. Second of that, I'm the manager of Queen of Africa International, empowering women, giving training, and so we have a training institute in South America for women that you know, with less education to have something and can start your own business.
Queen of Africa. You heard that.
I'm 30 years. If you want to know more, I leave you.
And she's my very good friend. She's my younger friend. Okay.
At the microphone now. Well, so you've seen her. If you want to exchange contacts, please do so. You see, these are some of the things which Africans or migrants in diaspora, not Africans, but migrants in diaspora are doing. And we've got to see know ourselves and appreciate ourselves. Thank you very much.
You.
I also have Christiana, right?
Yeah.
Miss Christine Abom, yes.
Come
please
on.
Come and share with us 1 minute what you're doing. Are you here? Is that your husband?
No.
Or your partner, your friend, okay.
Hello, good evening, everybody. I'm really grateful to be here. My name is Miss Among van der Plam, or Christine van der Plam. I'm still holding Mrs. van der Plam. I'm a chairperson of Foundation Mama Toto. Mama Toto, I know it means Toto in a different meaning in West African language, but it means a mother of children. Watoto means children. The foundation.
Uganda language? Or?
Uganda language, Swahili
okay.
Language.
Swahili,
okay. East African local language. We support women living with HIV. We support widows. We support child mothers, those ones who have come back from the rebel captivity.
Yeah.
I think everybody has heard about Mr. Konyi, who is terrorizing Uganda now for decades. So all those guys who came back with the children, we support them. Oh, we're also working with the street children. Thank you, my sister. Maybe I will meet you later on. Yes,
sure.
We support all those people. But here also in the Netherlands, we organize the programs on different topics, such as like this one. We organize programs concerning female genital mutilation, women trafficking, and of course integrating the different culture, upbringing of the children, and the parenting. Those are the things that we talk, and many more.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And you recently finished your project and they're looking for sponsors for the...
Yes. Just like this year, I was in Uganda with the MCRB, that is the Altered Watch. I think most of the people know that. We went all the way to Uganda to document the work that I'm doing there in Uganda. And it was on the Netherlands tour in July this year. Last year, we trained the 80 girls, the child mothers, on the tailoring. And we lacked funds to give them a starter kit because it's not good just to train them and just leave them like that. Then we have not done actually nothing. So we are looking for sewing machines to support them. So if anybody knows anybody who has a sewing machine, please, Mama Toto is in need of this.
That's good. Thank you very much. Yeah, applause. All right. I would like tonight to pass without acknowledging some special friends of ours. I'd like to acknowledge, well, first of all, Mr. Yao Abuaji. He is the concierge of the for this place. And it's awesome that he can take the time out to be here with us. Please give a big applause for that. And of course, I want to acknowledge the ministers who are here. Reverend Father Edmond is here.